Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Chris Badger. Thomas, right-wing Tribune. Iran has inked a deal to help rebuild Syrian army, says Assad allies and are ready to respond. Tehran officials claim Netanyahu is keeping Mideast in state of conflict to damage Tehran's economy and calls his threats to strike Iranian forces in Syria far from reality, Fox News reports. Iranian Defense Minister Amir Hatami said Syria's government is now in a stronger position and warned against any foreign aggression against Syria. Iran has signed a deal to rebuild Syria's armed forces, which have been depleted by more than 7 years' civil war, Iranian Defense Minister Amir Hatami said on Monday. Hatami, on a two-day visit to Syria, told the Beirut-based Al-Mayadeen TV station that the agreement also stipulates helping rebuild Syria's military industry. The announcement comes as the U.S. under President Donald Trump shifts his toughening its stance on Iran's support for Syrian President Bashar Assad's government, which has weathered a calamitous civil war. The White House has demanded that Iran extract itself from Syria as an essential precondition to lifting sanctions that went into effect earlier this month. We can ensure the security of the Persian Gulf and there is no need for the presence of aliens like the U.S. and the countries whose home is not in here. All the carriers and military and non-military ships will be controlled and there is full supervision over the Persian Gulf. Our presence in the region is physical and constant and night and day, tilde Iran's Revolutionary Guards General Ali Reza Tangziri, a top Navy general in Iranian, said Monday the country took full control of the Gulf and the Strait of Hormuz, a major shipping route that the Iranians threatened to block in the past amid worsening American-Iranian relations. From the time that Trump announced the withdrawal from the nuclear deal, America has not been able to reach its goals. There are some in the country who, instead of laying the groundwork for using the opportunities presented by the nuclear deal, chose a political fight. And this political fight led to despair and disappointment, which has America's focus on a psychological war against Iran and its business partners. Of course, our distrust of the U.S. is clear. We are different from others in the region and they think that they can buy security and progress for themselves by purchasing weapons and nuclear weapons, but the Islamic Republic is different and it relies on its people for security and progress. America has failed, Trump has failed, tilde Foreign Minister Mohammad Javad Zarif, RWT. Full report here. HT Times of Israel. Chris Badger. Thomas is a veteran who served our country as an army combat medic. God bless. Dean James III, percent right-wing Tribune. Be sure to follow us on Nation in Distress and America's Freedom Fighters on Facebook.